What up, y'all? This is Todd Kilsom, and today we're going to dive within the sound wave of Dreams to Reality. As a kid, I was always daydreaming. Now I really sleep, so I chase dreams and keep pigs screaming. Hit the studio as opposed to staying around the way, beefing with the same niggas. I stay singing. As a kid, I always daydreamed, meaning I always saw something outside of my reality. And nowadays, I chase those dreams as opposed to staying boxed in within that reality, because I'm used to seeing in the neighborhood where people are beefing and having issues, where I'm busy looking past that and chasing a dream to make things happen.
Stay dreaming, but never spend a day sleeping. Move with a more productive, positive way to stay scheming.
I'm saying that I stay dreaming, but I never spend a day sleeping. And it's simple. I recognize the dream. I understand what I have to go after. I understand that it's very important to dream, but I make sure that I stay scheming on it. So I need to be awake to actually chase those dreams. I'm not actually sleeping when I'm dreaming. I'm chasing the dreams in my reality.
My eyes been on this rap for a minute, so when I'm in it, I ain't leaving. You can choose to sit with the usual, smoking crucial, Facebook and the misuse of finance on YouTube. Got my eyes on something bigger, like Google.
So following right after that, I say once I'm in it, I ain't leaving. So I'm chasing this music. I'm chasing the music, and I'm unlike a lot of the people that are already in the game who feel like they don't want to be in the game. I actually strive to get there, so when I make it there, I'm not leaving. This is where I belong. And you can choose to leave when you get there, choose to spend your days smoking out. You can choose to spend your days looking at stuff on YouTube and laughing at people doing stupid stuff on the internet. But I got my eyes on something bigger like Google, just meaning that I'm trying to build something that large, to where you don't have to know about computers to know about Google. And I want to be that guy where you don't have to know about rap to know about Todd Kilsom.
I choose to make a record pop without pop, work ethic like pop.
I want to make a record pop without pop. So I want it to be huge, but I don't want it to be a pop song. You know, it can be popular, but not what you think of when you hear a pop song. And I'm saying my work ethic is like Pac, because when I think about Tupac, it's not the way a lot of people think of him. I look at him like he died in 96. My son was born in 2007, and he's very aware of who Tupac is. My goal here is to live forever, which is why I work that hard.
Force my thoughts to sin like when a weapon gets popped. Stop, you're not even on the old me level. Put a curve on the design like the old E letters.
Pen force my thoughts to sin like when a weapon gets popped. So anybody that knows anything about like weapons, you know how important a firing pin can be. You remove that, it's not firing. So I'm saying that my pen, also the pen of the weapon, it forced the thoughts to sin like when the pen, the firing pin, has a weapon pop. And then I say stop. I'm just pretty much ending it all here, like, okay, stop, y'all get that much. And then I let all my competition know, you're not even on the old me level. So the guy I was 5 years ago, you're not there yet. And my whole plan is to put a curve on a design. So the whole idea of how you look at things, where it's just pretty blocky. Everybody say, give it to me straight up. My idea is to put a curve on it to work for me. And if you look at old E letters or old English, you'll notice that it's all curves.
Yeah. Making millions off of tragedies, casually making beats of casualties. I'm actually turning my dreams to reality. Go to work happily and work till insanity. Makes sense, turning sense to a pile of cheese. Dreams to reality, turn my dreams to reality.
Making millions off of tragedies. Pretty much, I'm a strong believer of, you don't really have bad things, you just have hard lessons. So all of the tragedies in my life has all turned into a happy ending. And that's part of the reason why I rhyme the way I rhyme. So my goal is to make millions off of my tragedy. Then I go into how I casually make beats casualties. So the whole idea is, it look effortless. When you're standing on the outside, you see me rhyme, I'm pretty laid back, I'm pretty calm, because it's just casual, it's a regular day for me. But I'm making the beat a casualty. I'm gonna kill this beat. I mean, that's just a pretty simple thing for all artists out there. If you're like a real hip-hop head, then you know the goal is to destroy this. And then I go into the dream of making those tragedies into millions is actually happening. That's why I say I'm turning my dreams to reality. And the goal is to go to work happily. Because they say that if you're happy with your job, you'll never work a hard day in your life. You'll never work a day in your life. So my goal is to go to work happily and work, overwork, and work to a point where people say you're crazy for working that hard. So I say work till insanity makes sense. And I jump off of the sense, like, you know, it makes sense to you to make sense, like make dollars. Work till insanity makes sense and turns sense into a pile of cheese. Pile of cheese, dough, money. You gotta know at least that much if you're watching.
I rap and I see clear that I work all the time on my rhymes, but what's work when you happy to be there? I don't see where niggas lost their love for motivational music, now replaced with the confrontational movement.
I'm very clear on what I'm saying and what I'm doing. I know exactly what I'm going for. So I say I work and I see clear that I work on my rhymes all the time. So it's very clear that I'm always working and perfecting my craft. Even if you say I'm the best, my goal is to be better than that tomorrow. My whole idea of it is, what's work if you're happy to be there? Just going back off the hook. Go to work happily and work till insanity. Makes sense. So I'm just playing right off the hook, going right into that, letting you know that I always work on my craft, but it doesn't feel like work because I'm happy to be there. And then I go straight into where people would say my competition gets lost. Even a lot of the guys that I like, that I loved before, they seem to have fell back. They seem to be falling out of love with their message. And my goal is to make sure that I stay on that. So there's not a problem with the idea of motivation. The issue is it was replaced with confrontation. So when people stopped finding clever ways to motivate people, they started finding ways to put people in their crosshairs.
True, niggas beef before, but it ain't changed the quality of what we see in the CD stores. This useless excuse for music is unlike anything that I've seen before.
All right, so playing right off of where people are more confrontational, I'm aware that people beefed. It's always happened. But it didn't change the quality of the music. Maybe they had one song or one verse or one line that was going at another artist, but the message never wavered. It didn't go too far, of course. Where now, people are disguising terrible rap lyrics under, I hate him, I shot him, I did this, I did that. My goal here is just to say, hey, I'm not worried about your confrontation, I'm not worried about your beef, but if it changes the music you're giving me, I then have an issue. If all you can do is make beef records, I'm a little bored. But if you do have that motivational content, you do have a story to tell, and you just so happen to jump off track to kick somebody's ass, I'm cool with that.
How long has it been since you heard something clean that's raw? I'm needed just as much as I need this, and I need it like right now. Linda Millions can't put the mic down. Powerful slogans and everything that I type now or write down.
Playing right off of from the confrontation, changing the whole idea of the way music is and people focusing on beef than the actual content, I go into how long has it been since you heard something clean this raw. This goes plenty of different ways. If we're going off of the beef, anybody that's cooked, you know when you're dealing with raw meat, you need to clean up a lot. So something clean is raw. If you go into this verse, you'll realize that the verse is pretty clean up to this point as far as curse words and things of that nature, but it's still raw, where a lot of people are listening and they don't consciously realize that I've went this far without dropping any F-bombs. And then I go into, I'm needed just as much as I need this, and I need it like right now. So this is me admitting that my relationship with music is mutual. I need this type of music. And because this type of music is not readily available, the music needs me in order to deliver that. So it's just kind of me being cocky, but also being aware of what's going on around me. My love for all of this. So my next line is, Lendo Millions, I can't put the mic down, to say that this has nothing to do with money. When I'm broke, I rap. When I'm rich, I rap. When I'm tired, I rap. When I'm energized, I rap. This is what I do all the time. This is what I'm gonna do. And nothing's gonna change that. And then I follow that with, because the way my brain works, there's powerful slogans in everything that I write now.
I'm ahead of everybody, but never ahead of myself. All right, now you can say that I ain't nice now, but I'll destroy whatever artist you like now, or whoever's receiving the most hype now. Ty kills them.
I'm ahead of everybody, but never ahead of myself. And that's just saying that I'm fully aware that I'm ahead of a lot of my competition, which is why I don't really see them. But you know the saying, don't get ahead of yourself. When someone thinks that they're so far ahead of the game, they tend to lose their self, and that's when they trip up and they lose momentum, and we watch the people that we thought was infallible crash. So I'm never ahead of myself. And then it's just kind of like me reiterating, all right, now, you get it? And then just following up with, you can say that I ain't nice now, but I'll destroy whatever artist you like now. So I'm saying I don't care about what age group, I don't care what kind of music he does, bar for bar, I'm that confident that I'll win. And that's why I ended off with, or whoever's receiving the most hype now, Ty kills him. For those that don't know, I got the name Ty kills him because I didn't have a rap name. My name was Ty, and they say that I kill him. Put me up against anybody and I kills him. So, whoever's receiving the most hype now, Ty kills them. And that's within the sound wave of Dreams to Reality, off of the Dos Equis album. Y'all make sure y'all go ahead and get that. And I'm Ty Kills Them. Peace.